What's up, YouTube? Slim here at Team Symmetry, here to do my honest thoughts on Tour Bus from the Underworld. Before I get started, I'm in an amazing mood today, just like an amazing mood. It's been a great day. I got to the gym, I worked out. I got my shoes, and I am fucking psyched, like literally. Like, I came home after the gym, you know, got breakfast, all that crap. Went out, had to buy some shit, came back, and motherfucker, they're here, and I'm very happy. I don't know, a lot of people are Nike fans, but I like old school Nikes, and these are custom black and green. I called them my black and green, my marijuana, or my black and green Oakland Athletic dunks. I've been looking for a pair of black and green forever, and I found them, and they are here, and they are beautiful, and I'm a very, very, very happy Slim. Yeah, they're just awesome. Because green is hard to come by. And also, you know, you can be green with envy, green if you're Irish, green for money, you know, whatever. Fuck it. These are just fucking amazing. I'm very happy. So I just wanted to share that with you guys to start off my video. I'm in a very good mood. Plus, I'm rocking purple, so it's a good day. But I'm here to talk about what everyone and their mother's been talking about for the last couple of days. Came out Christmas Eve. It was our little Christmas present from Konami. Tour Bus from the Underworld. All right, so let's back up a little bit. First, we have Her tour guide from the Underworld. Came out, people didn't really know what this card was all about, and it was like, okay, it's a cute picture. I mean, let's not lie, a lot of guys, a lot of people, even myself, will admit it's a really cute picture, and it's really good art on Konami's part. Everyone didn't know that this was, you know, people thought, oh, this is just to promote Exceeds, whatever, blah 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 blah. This card was valued roughly at $30. In the blink of an eye, this card goes up to 70, to 100, to 150, to now, from what I've heard, it could go up to almost 200 because of Tour Bus. This card has been seen, of course, in Tengu Plants. It's been seen in some TGs. It's been seen in a lot of decks. Agents. Every deck is trying to make it work. It's amazing in Dark World. I just played on Dueling Network, and I'm running Dark World Turbo. I'm trying out Turbo because I haven't decided. You know, that was an option given to me by one of my subscribers plus one of my teammates. Shout out to Big Surge. He kicked my ass yesterday. Him and Max C are like this. Like, it's amazing. It's crazy, but I do like the turbo version, so I'm gonna try that out, maybe profile it, and that might be my regional deck. It's just a regional, so it doesn't really matter. But back to tour guide, tour bus, and all this shit. So tour guide is a very expensive card, we're not gonna lie. The hype in this card, people are saying this card is overhyped. Yes and no. This card is really good. You can't deny that this card is good. This card is an instant plus one. Plus, you can exceed going into Zen Main's turn one is just a bitch. Just a bitch, because it takes several ways to destroy that thing unless you're fortunate enough to make Brio or do something that can get rid of it immediately, but it's a bitch. And tour guide now, I want to say, is roughly valued maybe 150-ish. It could be more. I have not looked. I honestly have not looked. I honestly don't care, because I'm not getting rid of my tour guide, so it doesn't even matter. Sorry, Nima, you're not getting my tour guide. But here's the thing. This card is good on its own. It's good, you know, if you run three with Sangin, you know, if you're running Dark World, you have Brow. But they give the bitch a bus. They give the bitch a bus. And this tour bus, let me see. I don't have, like, the technology to record shit. But here we go. Little bitch on the bus. You can see it on my smartphone. That's Slim's smartphone. It's an okay phone. It's not an iPhone, but it'll do. All right. So you got the bitch. She's got her bus. She's got soul-absorbing bone tower in the back. All right. So all you need to know. Level 3, Dark, of course, it's a fiend. When this card is sent to the graveyard, you can target one monster in either player's graveyard, except Tour Bus, so you can't target the Tour Bus, and you can shuffle that card back into the deck. Okay, it's a little mini Avarice. People want to know, is that even good? Like, is it worth the wait? Is all this hype? Was this really, is this what we were waiting for? The effect was blurred out, which is very rare for Konami to do. This might actually be the first time. You know, if it isn't, you know, let me know, but they blur out the effect. And you're just left wondering, what the fuck does this card do? What a rarity is it going to be? What's going on? And, I mean, I was the same way. As soon as my teammates and Vexy, shout out to Vexy, told me about there was going to be a tour bus, I thought they were shitting me. I thought, you're kidding me, right? Sent me links, sent me everything, it's official, it's being released. But the effect, of course, was blurred. Because it's like, we want you to buy Tour Guide. This is Konami. We want you to buy Tour Guide. Make us money, make us money, make us richer and richer and richer. Make us green with envy like my fucking shoes. Ridiculous. And to be honest, I expected a little bit better, but I'm not gonna say that this card is not good, because the plays that Surge did yesterday proved it. We're playing, he goes tour guide and tour bus, makes Zen mains, I have to try and get Zen Mains off the field. He does his own crazy pro play, and Tour Bus gets detached and goes to the grave. Here's the thing, people might not know. I'm sure you do by now because everyone's made this video. But Tour Bus is like Dandelion. When it is detached, you do get the effect. I don't know 100% why. I know it's something, some crazy complicated thing, and I honestly just, I don't have, I guess, like the right vocabulary at this current moment to explain it. But it's like Dandelion when it detaches and hits the graveyard. It triggers in the graveyard and it lets you use the effect. It's unlike Sangen, because Sangen has to be destroyed, and that's not technically destroy it. I think it's because it's sent, and like Dandelion sent, you get your token. So Tour Bus, you get the effect. Pro Play Surge did. He did it to my Graffa, sending Graffa back to my deck. That was the only Graffa in grave. Completely ruined my whole game because I needed Graffa in the grave. There's one pro play with it. Other pro plays: recycle tour guide, recycle something in plants, recycle your bulb, recycle whatever. If you haven't used one for one or lone fire, recycle whatever you need. It's a recycle effect. It's really good in that sense. It's really good in the sense that it can screw your opponent over. That's about it, though. That's all I see right now. I see it. You gotta have Zen mains. You gotta use Zen mains. Because, I mean, you got a wall, and then when you detach, regardless, you're getting the effect. It's really, really good. And honestly, though, I don't see this card being ran in three. I think maybe two or one max, just for the fact that Tour Guide has, still has Sangen, still has itself. And if you're running Dark World like I am, you still have Brow. I honestly would run one. I would not probably run more than one. So when the preview comes, I'll look for one, try it out. I'm gonna try it out on Dueling Network eventually, but since it won't be out for regionals, I'm gonna wait till after regionals, just to be fair, because that's how I play. I don't like adding cards to a deck I don't have and I know I'm not going to get in time for regionals. I just think that's bullshit. It's like you're thinking ahead, but when you do have an event, if you're practicing with something you don't have when you're in real life and you're playing and you don't have that card and you realize it, and you're like, oh fuck, that plays out of options, then you're kind of backed into a corner. Just saying, that's from personal experience. But honest opinion about tour guide, tour bus, all this tour shit is that, it's you, Konami. You want us to spend a lot of money to be considered a good player, to be considered a pro player, whatever the fuck you want to call it. And you know what? My phone just vibrated. I wonder what's up. But honestly, it's just it's up to the player. I have my set of tour guides. Several people on Team Symmetry have their sets of tour guides, and we're not planning, to stop running tour guide. It's good, but I feel for the underdog player, for the players that aren't able to afford tour guides or trade for tour guides or are fortunate enough to pull them in packs like Nima did. Not gonna forget, Nima pulled the tour guide. It's not fair because you're being told that you're only considered pro or good or on the level of other players if you have these cards, and that's complete bullshit. Let the record show people who have ran Dark World and ran Skill Drain and not ran Tour Guides still topped. They still topped. They still were successful. Some decks say Tour Guide is absolutely essential. Most decks can run without it unless you're running plants. They say you have to run Tour Guide, and they're right. You have to run Tour Guide, you have to untangle all that crap. But honestly, at the end of the day, you as a player will know if this card suits, your play style. I never thought it would suit mine. When the opportunity was there, I took it. I was like, this is my one chance to get them. I have to get them. I have to jump on this. And it's not to jump on the bandwagon. I know how good they are. I have to do that. And that was a personal decision on my part. Now a tour bus coming out next year, which is funny to say because it's only like it's a couple days away for the new year, and yeah. I feel that one will be all I need for now. And I just hope that they don't. I mean, I know they're gonna overhype this card. They're gonna make this card easily $75 or more when it comes out. It's probably gonna be a secret, just like Tour Guide, and they're making Tour Guide or this whole tour shit into a very expensive archetype. And I just think it's unfair for players that aren't able to get them. Now, I don't want anyone to be like, oh, but you have them. I explained to you why I have them, and that's what I'm trying to convey with this video is that regardless, I don't think it's fair to players who aren't able to get them. Now, there's talk of a tour guide reprint. I'm all for it, to be honest. They've done it to Duality, they've done it to Warning. I had my sour thoughts about that, and now with them both out, I'm not running either of them, which is pretty, interesting. I think, like, to me, it's interesting because I used to love Duality. I used to love Warning. I still love them. They're just not needed in the decks I run. And it's interesting how things change, you know, over time. But that's pretty much all I have to say. You know, let me know what you guys think. Is Tour Bus good or bad? I know everyone says this shit. Everyone's like, you know, let me know. Is this card good? You know, leave your comments below. And I mean, that's how these videos go, unfortunately. I mean, I'm just being honest. You know, like, let me know what you guys think. Honest opinions. How many would you run if you had the chance? Do you think it's total crap? Tell me if it's total crap. Because at first glance, I was like, oh, this is total crap. Not even gonna lie. All this waiting for what? Bitch's bus. It's not even that great. It's not even like the Magic School Bus. Shit does not go. Just saying. But let me know what you guys think. Because this card will be out. This will be the it card to get. Instead of it girl, this will be the it card to get. And we'll see what happens. So that's all I got to say on that topic. Last thing I want to do, I want to give a shout out to Test Tiger 23's channel. A really cool guy, name's John. Always hits me up on Dueling Network when I'm there. He's a big fan of my videos. I'm shouting him out because he asked me for a shout out, and also he was my 25th like on my video. I think it was it yesterday, day after Christmas? I don't remember. It was yesterday. The yesterday was the day after Christmas. See, I'm totally just like razzled, but I wanted to shout him out. Really cool guy, really cool channel. He's really trying to come up in YugiTubing, like all of us are, of course. And he's got really good videos. He's able to record his DN stuff, and I mean that's something I can't do yet. So I mean, big shout out to him. You know, thank you for being, you know, one of my loyal subscribers. You know, thank you for your contributions and you know everything. And I just want to shout you out. I'm gonna have an annotation up here somewhere. You know, please check out his channel. Really cool guy, and you know, just really trying to come up. And I mean, you have to respect that. So that's pretty much all I got to say, you guys. This was my little tour bus tour shit rant. Rant video, whatever. It's what I promised you guys. I'm gonna be doing some deck profiles as well. I gotta do my little brother's deck profile. Shout out to Dark Lord Desire 225. And I got a couple more deck profiles coming up, so just stay tuned for those. That's all I gotta say, you guys. Please like this video. You guys always know the more likes I get, the more content I will upload, and I will do it in a speedy fashion. So that's all I gotta say, you guys. Slim here, Team Symmetry. I'm very happy I got my shoes. I am just, one last time. I am just woo! I'm very happy I got my shoes, and I'm rocking purple. That's all I gotta say, you guys. Thank you for being, you know, just thank you for watching my content, and thank you know, for all, you know, that you guys do for me. It really means a lot. And I'll be having my contest up soon for the Pathway to Partnership, so stay tuned for that. It'll be probably in the next couple days to weeks, and will hopefully get me there. That's all I got to say, you guys. Slim here at Team Symmetry. Hope everyone has a good day, and thank you for watching.